ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్, వెల్కమ్ బ్యాక్. సో లెట్ అస్ కంటిన్యూ 7th ఏ గ్రూప్. ద నెక్స్ట్ ఎలిమెంట్ ఈస్ బ్రోమిన్. సో స్టార్టింగ్ విత్ ద ప్రిపరేషన్ మెథడ్స్, the preparation methods are similar to that of chlorine, right? So let us see the first one. By displacement of bromides, so if I take potassium bromide, chlorine can displace bromine from bromides, because a more electronegative element can displace less electronegative element if it carries negative oxidation state. So here bromine carries -1. What we get is 2KCl plus Br2. 2KCl plus Br2. So if I assign the oxidation states, bromine -1, 0. Chlorine 0, -1. So this is how you have to remember. A more electronegative element displaces less electronegative element from its anion salts. The next one is, you can also do with fluorine also, no problem with that. The next one is by oxidation with MnO2. Is some oxidizing agent. So we take some salt of bromide, and convert it into Br2, right? So the whole process is involves removal of electron. A substance which oxidizes, this process is oxidation. See here, the oxidation state changes from -1 to 0. Therefore, it is oxidation. This process is oxidation. For oxidation, we require oxidizing agent. So we are taking the oxidizing agent as MnO2. So we require a salt of bromine. So let us take sodium bromide or potassium bromide, right? In acidic medium plus MnO2. Right. So bromine changes from -1 to 0. Similarly, the oxidizing agent itself has to undergo reduction. To which oxidation state it will undergo reduction? First identify the oxidation state of manganese here. It is +4. It will be reduced to +2, right? So +2. So the anions are provided by medium, that is sulfuric acid. What is the anion? Sulfate, SO4-2. Now one more question. Does manganese dioxide oxidize sulfuric acid? Answer is no. The reason is sulfur is already present in its higher oxidation state, that is +6. Next, H+ already present in +1 oxidation state. Sodium already present in +1 oxidation state, cannot oxidize oxygen because it releases oxygen itself, right? So sulfur cannot be oxidized. It is a medium that provides, that maintains acidic condition and provides the anions. The anions it provides is sulfate ions. Mn+4 changes to Mn+2. Mn+4 changes to Mn+2. So Mn+2 SO4-2. What we get? MnSO4. Sodium do not undergo any change. So you will get here bisulfate NaHSO4. Right, NaHSO4, and of course we require bromine. Bromine will be obtained with water. So you have to balance this. Two sodium bisulfates because we require Br2, so I am taking 2 NaBr, 2 sodiums, 2 bisulfate. Here one sulfate, here one sulfate, total 3 H2SO4. 2 hydrogens we got here out of 6, therefore it should be 2 H2O. I think it is balanced. So we have 2 oxygens, 2 oxygens are lost as water. Right. So let us see the change in the oxidation state. Once again, manganese changes from plus 4 to plus 2. So this is oxidizing agent. Right. Now coming to bromine, Br minus 1 to 0. It undergoes reduction. It is a reducing agent. It itself undergoes oxidation. Coming to the third one. Right, by heating potassium bromide, bromate, potassium bromate in presence of HCl. So here both bromines in acidic medium, right, they are converted to Br2, comp proportionation reaction you can say. It's a comp proportionation here. Bromine oxidation state is minus 1. Here it is plus 5. Changes to 0. Reverse of disproportionation. So 3 oxygens. So 3 H2O definitely. 6 hydrogens. So I will take 6 HCl. So 6 chlorines. 6 KCl. 6 potassiums. So I cannot change the coefficient of this because already I have fixed 3. So I will place here 5 because already there is 1 bromine here. 5 plus 1, 6. 5 potassium plus 1, 6. 6 potassium. So it is balanced. So these are the preparation methods. Let us study the physical properties of bromine. It is reddish brown, heavy liquid. Because its mass is more, so density will be more. Reddish brown, heavy, mobile liquid, it moves, no problem, right? Next, its boiling point is around 301.5 Kelvin and melting point is 265.7 Kelvin. So less than room temperature, boiling point, it's a liquid. See here, it's a liquid at room temperature, but you can see those red, orange, red vapors. It is soluble in water. It dissolves in water and forms hydrates upon cooling. Forms hydrates upon cooling. Like Br2 dot 10H2O. So it is soluble in water, slightly soluble in water, but more soluble in organic solvents. More soluble in organic solvents like alcohols, ethers, carbon disulfide, chloroform, etc. It is poisonous in nature. Corrosive and attacks skin. సో చేతి మీద పడితే బొబ్బలు వస్తాయి. అటాక్ స్కిన్ ప్రొడ్యూసింగ్ సోర్స్ కాసెస్ సోర్స్ పొక్కులు బబుల్స్. సో పాయిజనస్, యూ షుడ్ నాట్ ఇన్హేల్ ద గ్యాస్. కరోసివ్ రెడీలీ అటాక్స్ ఎనీ మెటీరియల్, ఈట్స్ అవే మెటల్స్. అటాక్స్ స్కిన్, ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఫాల్స్ ఆన్ ద స్కిన్ బై మిస్టేక్ యూ విల్ గెట్ సోర్స్ ఆన్ ద స్కిన్. ఇట్ టర్న్స్ స్టార్చ్ పేపర్, స్టార్చ్ సొల్యూషన్ టు ఎల్లో. సో వన్ ఐడెంటిఫికేషన్ టెస్ట్. సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఫిజికల్ ప్రాపర్టీస్. ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ రెడ్డిష్ బ్రౌన్ హెవీ మొబైల్ లిక్విడ్ విత్ బాయిలింగ్ పాయింట్ 301.5 కెల్విన్, మెల్టింగ్ పాయింట్ 265.7 కెల్విన. ఇట్ డిజాల్వ్స్ ఇన్ వాటర్ ఆన్ కూలింగ్. ఇట్ సపరేట్స్ యాజ్ క్రిస్టల్స్, హైడ్రేటెడ్ క్రిస్టల్స్ లైక్ Br210H2O. స్లైట్లీ సాల్యుబుల్ ఇన్ వాటర్ బట్ మోర్ సాల్యుబుల్ ఇన్ ఆర్గానిక్ సాల్వెంట్స్. పాయిజనస్ ఇన్ నేచర్, కరోసివ్. ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఫాల్స్ ఆన్ ద స్కిన్ ఇట్ కాసెస్ సోర్స్ అండ్ ఇట్ టర్న్స్ స్టార్చ్ టు ఎల్లో. దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఫిజికల్ ప్రాపర్టీస్. Now coming to the chemical properties. The chemical properties are similar to that of chlorine. Just you have to replace chlorine with bromine. So chemical properties are similar, same, similar to that of chlorine. So just go through the properties of chlorine. So the reactivity is slightly less, that is the only difference, and it is a liquid, but the reactions are almost similar to that of chlorine. So when you come to the uses, it is used as germicide, as oxidizing agent, and as lab reagent, and some more important, the compound of bromine AgBr, it is used in photography, in developing the film. So we'll study that part in hypo, and ethylene dibromide, one of the compound. It is used as additive in petrol. So these are some uses. So let us go for iodine. Starting with preparations. So most of the reactions are similar to that of bromine and chlorine. Starting with the first one, suppose if I have 2Ki and react it with chlorine. Chlorine displaces iodides from their salts, iodine from iodides. So what we get is 2KCl plus I2. This is strong oxidizing agent, so it liberates iodine from iodides. So we can assign the oxidation states here, -1, 0. So chlorine's oxidation changes from 0 to -1. So chlorine oxidizes, it itself undergoes reduction. Iodine act as reducing agent, so good reducing agent, -1 to 0. Chlorine displaces iodine from their iodides. Yes, you can also write with bromine also, 2Ki plus Br2 gives 2KBr plus I2, because bromine is also oxidizing agent, good oxidizing agent compared to iodine. Therefore, it also displaces iodine from iodides. The other reaction is by oxidizing agent, by treating with oxidizing agent. So we take salt of iodine where we have I minus converted to I2. So the process we call it as oxidation. Just now we have studied oxidation state changes from minus 1 to 0. So the process is oxidation. For that we require oxidizing agent. The oxidizing agent we are going to use is manganese dioxide, MnO2, where manganese changes from plus 4 to plus 2. It itself undergoes reduction. So by treating the salt, by heating the salt of iodine with manganese dioxide, you can take potassium iodide itself. So let us take Ki plus sulfuric acid plus manganese dioxide. So what happens here? Same story, just as we have studied in bromine. So sulfur cannot be oxidized, hydrogen cannot be oxidized, potassium cannot be oxidized. So it provides the acidic medium and provides the anions, you can say spectator ions. So the species that undergo change in oxidation states are iodine minus 1 to 0, and the other one is manganese, that is plus 4. So it changes to plus 2. The anions present in the solution, plenty of anions, are sulfate ions, combines with sulfate to form manganese sulfate. You will get potassium bisulfate, KHSO4, right, of course iodine, iron, water, right. So if I write the oxidation states, it is plus 2 here and this is 0. So two oxygens, that means 2H2O, so four hydrogens. So we have I2, right, so 2Ki, 2 potassiums, 2KHSO4, 2 hydrogens, 5, 6 hydrogens, so 3H2SO4, 3 sulfates, 2 sulfates plus 1, 3, it is balanced, 1 manganese, right. Anyway, iodine changes from minus 1 to 0, manganese changes from plus 4 to plus 2, remaining are other ions are spectator ions. Coming to the other examples, we can do the same type of preparation of iodine. We can liberate iodine from iodides by using any other strong oxidizing agents. So I minus 2 I2, we require oxidizing agent. This we can do by taking hydrogen peroxide, mild oxidizing agent, or I can take strong oxidizing agent in acidic medium, or I can even take potassium dichromate or even copper Cu plus 2. So let us see one by one. So first let us see with hydrogen peroxide. I am taking salt of potassium iodide, that is Ki, plus hydrogen peroxide in acidic medium. Now first, hydrogen peroxide is a mild oxidizing agent. Remember, it also acts as reducing agent, but here it acts as mild oxidizing agent. In hydrogen peroxide, we have peroxy bond like this. The oxidation state of oxygen is minus 1. It can undergo reduction to minus 2, minus 1 to minus 2. Therefore, it acts as mild oxidizing agent. Sulfuric acid, as I said earlier, sulfur present in plus 6 oxidation state, hydrogen cannot be oxidized, oxygen is already present in slower oxidation state. So, this oxygen that is present will be changed to O minus 2, minus 1 to minus 2. It itself will undergo reduction, therefore, it is oxidizing agent. So, let us proceed. Potassium cannot undergo any change, the oppositely charged ions present in the medium, right? Plenty is provided by the sulfuric acid, potassium plus sulfate, potassium ion plus sulfate, what we get? K2SO4, right? Of course, I2. H2O will be converted to H2O plus O2, sorry, nascent oxygen, H2O plus nascent oxygen. So, the nascent oxygen combines with remaining hydrogens to form water, alright, that is what we are writing. So, let us assign the oxidation state, let us balance first, okay. So, we have I here, we have I2. So, I am writing 2Ki, 2Ki means K2SO4, so only sulphate, 1H2O is sufficient. From here you will get 1H2O plus oxygen, here we have H2, so it should be 2H2O. Let us assign the oxidation state, iodine changes from minus 1 to 0, whereas that of peroxide, minus 1 per oxygen atom, I repeat, minus 1 per oxygen, actually it is O2 minus 2, there is nothing but O minus 1, minus 1 per oxygen, it is changed to O minus 2, minus 1 to minus 2. Right, so this is mild oxidizing agent. Now let us go for KMnO4. KMnO4 acts as powerful oxidizing agent. Of course, in different medium, we are taking acidic medium here, that is H2SO4. In acidic medium, manganese KMnO4, which is present in which oxidation state? Plus 7. In acidic medium, manganese changes from plus 7 to plus 2. Manganese changes from plus 7 to plus 2. That means 1 mole releases 5 moles of electrons. 1 mole releases how many moles of electrons? 5 moles of electrons. 5 moles of electrons. Here, I minus is converted into I2. So, with respect to I2, one mole formation of 1 mole of I2, formation of 1 mole of I2 involves removal of 2 moles of electrons. So, multiply this with 2, multiply this with 5. So, what we get is here you have to multiply with 2, right? Anyway, manganese changes to which oxidation state? Plus 2. Plenty of anions that remains as suspected ion sulfate. So, what we get is MnSO4. Potassium, no change. So, K plus only, plenty of sulfate ions, K2SO4. I minus changes to I2. Of course, water will be formed because this oxygen, it releases oxygens, right? So, first let us balance this. So, multiply this with 2, that means 2KMnO4. So, 2 manganese, 2 Mn versus MnSO4, K2SO4, right? Next, multiply this with 5 into 2, 10, therefore, 10Ki, here I will get 5. Total potassiums, 2 plus 10, 12, so it should be 6. 6 sulfates plus 2, that is nothing but 8H2SO4, therefore, what I will get is 8H2O, see here 2 into 4, 4 nascent oxygens, they are removed as water, 8H2O, right. So once again let us check whether it is balanced or not. Plus 7 to plus 2, change in oxidation state 5. Iodine minus 1 to 0. So let us see the next one, that is potassium dichromate. Potassium dichromate acts as oxidizing agent in acidic medium H2SO4. H2SO4. So what happens here? Chromium changes from plus 6 to plus 3. So per chromium change in units is 3, but one molecule contains 2 chromiums. So total change is 2 into 3, 6 units. So, one molecule requires 6 electrons. Now, who is going to provide this? Iodine. I minus converts into I2 plus 2 electrons. 2 moles gives 2 electrons. It requires 6. So, multiply this with 3. So, if I multiply with this 3, it becomes 6, right? Anyway, now see here, what are the products? Potassium combines with sulfate ions because it is not undergoing any change. Potassium sulfate, chromium plus 6 to plus 3, plus 6 to plus 3, chromium plus 3, oppositely charged ion sulfate. So crisscross method, what we get? Chromium sulfate Cr2SO4 taken thrice. Chromium in plus 3, it gives green color. So there is a change in the color. Some orange red to green color, that we will study in D block, right? No, iodine of course, I2 and water. So I have to balance these 7 oxygens. You have to get 7 H2O, right? Let us say. So this is multiplied with 1, this is multiplied with 3 because it should be equal to 6, right? 3 into 2, 6. So this is 6 Ki, so I will get 3 here. 6 potassium plus 2, total 8, therefore 4 sulfate plus 3, 7 H2SO4, now it is 7 H2O balanced. So assign the oxidation state. Chromium changes from plus 6 per chromium to plus 3 per chromium. So for one chromium it is plus 6, one molecule there are 2 chromiums, so total is 12 to 6, total change is 6. Now, coming to iodine, minus 1 to 0, minus 1 to 0. So, there is a beautiful color change, it is visible, hence this reaction can be used qualitatively also. Right. Apart from this, you can also use copper, as I said. So let us study about copper sulfate also. If I take copper sulfate, what is the oxidation state? Plus 2. So it reacts with potassium iodide. So there is nothing much, we can just interchange the ions. So what I will get is CuI2 plus K2SO4, that is what we get. Interchange of ions. Now here comes the chemistry. Copper iodide. Copper shows 2 oxidation states, plus 2, plus 1. In CuI2, copper is present in plus 2 and iodine is present in minus 1. Iodine in minus 1 oxidation state is a good reducing agent. Therefore, it reduces copper from plus 2 to plus 1. So this is unstable. The iodide ion reduces copper from plus 2 to plus 1, giving rise to Cu2I2, cupric iodide, ic, higher oxidation state, cupric iodide to cuprous, OUS, lower oxidation state. Now its oxidation state is plus 1, producing I2. So here copper changes from plus 2 to plus 1, iodine minus 1,
0. Here this itself is a good reducing agent, reduces copper from plus 2 to plus 1. In that process iodine is released.
So I minus is good reducing agent. So if the metal is present in higher oxidation state, then I minus will reduce that metal to its lower oxidation state. That is important with. These are the preparation methods. So let us study the physical properties and chemical properties. It is dark violet solid sublimates on heating. It is a dark violet solid, sublimates on heating. You know the meaning of sublimates on heating? When you heat it, it directly go into vapor state without going into the liquid state, solid to vapor state. Violet vapors, you can see its melting point is 387 Kelvin, boiling point is 457 Kelvin.
It is slightly soluble in water, but increases, but solubility increases in presence of Ki. Solubility increases in presence of Ki. What happens when I add Ki to water containing iodine? They react to form Ki3.
Due to this reaction, you will get I3 minus, more ionic compound. K plus I3 minus. Because of that, the solubility of I2 will increase. I2 itself is nonpolar, right? Because of less electronegativity difference, nonpolar, right? So it doesn't interact with polar molecule like water, but when you add Ki, the solubility increases because Ki converts I2 to Ki3, which is like ionic compound K plus I3 minus. The interaction with polar water molecule increases, therefore solubility increases. So slightly soluble in water, but solubility increases in presence of Ki due to the formation of Ki3, K plus I3 minus. So it can interact more easily with polar water molecule. There is attraction between solvent molecules and I3 minus ion, right? It is soluble more in I2, soluble more in organic solvents. Like CCl4, carbon disulfide, chloroform. So coming to the chemical properties. So it undergoes decomposition on heating. Effect of heat, you can write. It undergoes thermal decomposition on heating. So if I take I2 and heat it, it decomposes to iodine atom. The temperature, it starts at 973. But continues the dissociation even up to 1973 Kelvin.
With alkali, with bases, so same as that of chlorine, already we have studied. So I2 reacts with NaOH, undergoes disproportionation, cold and dilute, disproportionation, right? I2,
when it reacts with cold and dilute NaOH, undergoes a disproportionation to form
sodium iodide, like sodium chloride, sodium hypoiodide and water. So we have two sodiums, two H2O,
two oxidants balanced. You have to remember the change in oxidation state. As I said earlier, disproportionation 0 to minus 1 plus 1. That is important. So, coming to hot and concentrated, it undergoes decomposition here also, same decomposition. Hot and concentrated NaOH. So, it is a better oxidizing agent, you can say 5-NaI plus NaIO3 plus H2O, 6 hydrogen, therefore 3H2O. So, if you assign the oxidation states, iodine 0, minus 1, plus 5, same reaction which we have studied with chlorine. Bromine also gives same reaction. So, this is the reaction with alkali. Remember the change in oxidation state, that is important. 0 to minus 1, 0 to plus 1, disproportionation. 0 to minus 1, 0 to plus 5, disproportionation. Right. So, next reaction with say metals. So, metals directly combine highly electropositive metals to form corresponding iodides. Magnesium electropositive metal combine to form MgI2. Just write, remember the group number, write the corresponding salt. Aluminium, so AlI3, like AlCl3, AlI3. Sodium 0 to plus 1. Magnesium 0 to plus 2, group number 0 to plus 3. Iodine always good oxidizing agent. So, changes from 0 to minus 1, 0 to minus 1, 0 to minus 1. So, what happens with metals showing 2 or more variable oxidation states? Just now we have studied for copper. If metal shows 2 or more oxidation state, for example, copper shows 2 oxidation state, plus 2 iron, plus 1. Then what happens? If metal forms iodides in its higher oxidation state, then it decomposes to its lower oxidation state because I minus is a good reducing agent. So, if you have CuI2, that means copper is present in which oxidation state? Plus 2, it decomposes to lower oxidation state iodide, because I minus is good reducing agent. So, why this is happening? Because I minus is good reducing agent. Copper changes from plus 2 to plus 1. Similarly, you can write some more. Lead shows different oxidation state, plus 4. Plus 2, it is more stable in plus 2, inner pair effect. So, if I have PbI4, it readily decomposes to PbI2, right. Now, lead oxidation state changes from plus 4 to plus 2. It is because of strong reducing nature of I minus. So, if a metal shows 2 or more oxidation state, and if you have a heavier metal iodide, then it readily decomposes to lower oxidation state, stable lower oxidation state, because I minus is good reducing agent. With non-metals, the reaction with hydrogen is reversible. In fact, the reaction proceeds mostly in backward direction because I minus is good reducing agent. So, phosphorus, it can combine to form say PiE3. As I said, lower oxidation state is preferred. So with ammonia, iodine reacts with ammonia to form nitrogen triiodide. Nitrogen triiodide. This is nitrogen triiodide, a black explosive powder. So if you dry it, it explodes, liberating, decomposes, it decomposes, releasing nitrogen. So a mild explosion takes place. So decomposes with mild explosion. Nitrogen triiodide, the black explosive powder is called as nitrogen triiodide. Oxidation properties. So starting with H2S, let us say iodine shows some oxidation properties. So sulfur is present in -2 oxidation state, it is oxidized to sulfur. So here it is a mild oxidizing, weak oxidizing. So leftover is 2HI, it itself will undergo reduction. Reduction, let us indicate 0 to -1. If it is fluorine, you will get SF6, remember that. Next, say NaNO2 nitrite plus water plus I2, same as like hypochlorous, chlorine plus water, hypochlorous acid, you will get here also same thing, which is unstable, releases 2HI plus nascent oxygen, that nascent oxygen is added to NaNO2. So what I will get? NaNO3 plus 2HI. So NaNO2 to NaNO3, addition of oxygen, therefore oxidation state of nitrogen increases, we call it as oxidation. Iodine changes from 0 to -1, it itself will undergo reduction. Similarly, you can write some more. Sulfide, sodium sulfide, same way H2O plus I2, HI plus nascent oxygen, the nascent oxygen is added to Na2SO3, resulting in the formation of sulfate, sodium sulfate, Na2SO4, Na2SO3 to Na2SO4, number of oxygens are increased, oxidation state of sulfur increases, therefore it is oxidation. Iodine 0 to -1, it itself will undergo reduction, therefore it is oxidizing agent. You can write arsenic also, Na3AsO3H2O plus I2, nascent oxygen plus HI, that nascent oxygen is added to this Na3AsO3. So what I will get? Na3AsO4 plus 2 HI. Even you can convert ferrous sulfate to ferric, ferrous to ferric. So FeSO4 plus acidic medium plus I2, right. Same procedure, ferrous to ferric. Ferric means Fe2SO4 taken thrice, right, 2HI. So here ferrous to ferric. Iodine changes from 0 to -1. So these are some oxidation properties. So reaction with chlorates and bromates.
with chlorates and bromates.
Right, now see here.
2KCl plus I2, no reaction takes place, but 2KClO3 plus I2, what we get is potassium iodate plus Cl2.
Let us see the difference. Here chlorine is -1 oxidation state. Here chlorine is in +5 oxidation state. A less electronegative cannot displace more electronegative in its negative oxidation state, because the negative charge is more stabilized by more electronegative atom. Coming to here, a less electronegative atom can displace more electronegative atom if it is present in positive oxidation state, because the positive oxidation state makes it more and more electronegative. Therefore, this iodine can displace chlorine from potassium chlorate, liberating chlorine. So +5 to 0. Here it is present in -1 oxidation state, here it is present in +5 oxidation state, thereby it becomes more electronegative. Similarly, I can write for bromine also. Same reason you can give. So iodine can displace chlorates, chlorine and bromine from chlorates and bromates, but iodine cannot displace chlorine and bromine from their chlorides and bromides, because in chlorides and bromides chlorine bromine carry negative charge, whereas in chlorates and bromates chlorine and bromine carry positive charge. That is how you have to remember. Next, reaction, they have completed oxidation properties, right? So with oxidizing agents, with oxidizing agents, right? So here first with nitric acid. First, is nitric acid is an oxidizing agent? Yes, it is a powerful oxidizing agent. The reason is nitrogen is present in its higher oxidation state. If an element is present in its higher oxidation state, then it will act as oxidizing agent. So if I take iodine and nitric acid, remember iodine is oxidized to iodic acid, right? That is what you have to do. Iodic acid, HIO3. Nitrogen is strong and powerful oxidizing agent, therefore it is oxidized to iodic acid, HIO3. Nitrates, they will be reduced to NO2, and hydrogens, you may get water, I2, so 2HIO3, 2 into 3, 6 oxygens, so 6 oxygens we have here, here we have H2, so we cannot balance like that. So you are getting from nitrate, NO3 is converted to NO2, it is losing 1 oxygen, so we already got 6 here, so it should be greater than 6. Okay, let us write like this, 0 to plus 5, here 3 to the 6, 1, 5. So it is gaining 1 electron, here it is losing 10 electrons, 2 into 5, 10, so it should be 10, I have to take 10 molecules, 0 to 5, losing 5 electrons per iodine, we have I2, therefore 10,
So this 10 electrons it has to gain, but one nitrogen gains only one electron. Therefore, 10 nitrate ions should be converted into 10 NO2. So we have 10 hydrogens. Here we have 2. Therefore, it should be 4 H2O10. Okay. 10 NO2s. So 10 oxygens you have to balance. 2 into 3, 6 plus 4, 10 balanced. Plus 5 to plus 4, 0 to plus 5. Yes. So this is iodic acid. Iodic acid. Next, with ozone. Ozone is also good oxidizing agent. Ozone oxidizes I2 to iodic if it is moist. Moist means water. You have to add some water. Ozone. So what I will get? Iodic acid HiO3. We have two iodines, therefore 2 HiO3. We require 6 oxygens. We require 6 oxygen, right? So one already we have here, so we require 5 more. So 5O3, 5O3 converts into 5O2, 0 to plus 5, so 5 ozones balanced, 0 to plus 5. Next, if it is dry iodine, it is converted into an LO powder, I4O9. LO powder. So 4 iodines, 2i2, 9 oxygens, 9O3, we get 9O2. So this is with ozone. Ozone oxidizes moist iodine to iodic acid, dry iodine to LO powder. With chlorine water. So you know the meaning of chlorine water, chlorine plus water. I2 plus Cl2 plus H2O. Here also it converts into iodic acid. So what is the formula of iodic acid? HiO3. So 2 iodines, 2. So we require 6 oxygens. So I would take 6 H2O. So already we have 2 hydrogens out of 12. So left over is 10 HCl. So it should be 5Cl2. So these are the reactions with oxidizing agents. Next, with mercuric oxide. So when iodine is heated with mercuric oxide, right, so what we get here is HgO HgI2. And HgO, mercuric iodide, and HOI, hypoiodous acid. So we have to add water also. Hypoiodous acid. So when heated with mercuric oxide, you'll get hypoiodous acid, like HOCl. So these are some reaction. It reacts with starch also. Right. Dark blue color, turn starch to dark blue color. So let us study the uses. Iodine is used as lab reagent in laboratory and in volumetric analysis. For example, estimation of hypo Na2S2O3, very important reaction, converts into Na2S4O6 plus 2NaI. Hypo reacts with iodine to form sodium tetrathionite and sodium iodide. So we study this reaction in iodometric, iodometric titration, in volumetric analysis, right?
indirect analysis which we studied in stoichiometry, right? Again we'll study in while studying hypo in detail.
It is used in the preparation of iodoform, iodoform reaction, haloform reaction. We study in organic chemistry, CHI3 and iodol, iodex.
These are used as antiseptic, disinfectant, and used in the preparation of dyes. Disinfectant, antiseptic, and dye stuffs.
And tincture of iodine. Tincture of iodine is a mixture of Ki plus I2 in alcohol, which is used as antiseptic. Antiseptic or analgesic also. Iodine deficiency causes, iodine deficiency causes a disease called goiter. Goiter is the name of the disease.
Iodine deficiency causes goiter.
And radioactive iodine is used for treatment of thyroid gland problem.
So if you have thyroid gland problem, radioactive iodine is used for the treatment. Right.